Obviously, it's a combination of a helicopter and a plane.
Exactly. So it can take off like a helicopter, but it flies with the efficiency of an airplane.
Bevirt has been working on the Joby for more than a decade. It has 6 propellers and 4 batteries in its wings and will operate as an air taxi, carrying a pilot and 4 passengers. He says it can fly 150 miles on a single charge and has a top speed of around 200 miles an hour.
Why this design?
So vertical takeoff is important so we can take you to where you want to go, right? We don't need a huge runway. And then with the wing, it gives you the efficiency to fly far and to fly fast.
Pilot, you're cleared. Flight Box Alpha Blow.
Because it's still being tested, the Joby was piloted remotely by a nearby ground crew.
Launch for flight.
When they fired up the motors, unlike a helicopter, the Joby didn't need time to warm up. It took off in about 20 seconds.
That's it? That's really quiet.
We wanted this to sound more like the wind in the trees than the wop-wop of a helicopter.
Noise levels are a critical issue since eVTOLs are meant to take off and land near where people work and live.
This is below the background noise level of many cities. You know, I go around with my decibel meter on my phone and, like, measure sound levels.
That's what you've been doing for 10 years?
Exactly, because we needed to make sure that the aircraft was going to be quiet enough.
Bevirt studied mechanical engineering at Stanford, where he invented this popular flexible camera tripod, and later created a company that made flying wind turbines. But the Joby had remained an elusive dream.
There were definitely skeptics, even, you know, good friends of mine, who didn't believe that you could make this with batteries and electric propulsion.
The battery technology just wasn't there, it wouldn't work.
Yeah.
Bevirt hired John Wagner away from Tesla, where he helped develop the car's revolutionary batteries. At Joby, he figured out a way to make the batteries lighter, but still powerful enough to get the 2-ton eVTOL off the ground.
You had to play to the strengths of battery power and the strengths of electric motors. So a typical aircraft might have one big motor, but we can have 6 motors distributed throughout the aircraft. And in that way, operate in a much more efficient manner.
The weight of everything must be the most important thing.
Absolutely.
So how do you make a plane as light as possible?
You essentially have to engineer every piece of it.
The outside of the Joby is made with layers of lightweight carbon fiber. The batteries, as well as computers, electronics, and motors, are constructed under John Wagner's watch. And his team shakes, bakes, and spins them to ensure they'll meet the FAA's rigorous safety standards.
They have to certify the aircraft as being safe and capable of flying to their standards. They also have to certify the production of all the parts of it.
Exactly, and the operation, the pilot training, the maintenance steps, every facet is heavily regulated.
All this costs a lot of money. Toyota has invested about $400 million in Joby, and Bevirt took the company public last year.